Thank you for joining me on this session of Sunday Reflection. I'll look back at my Sunday sermon here at First Assembly of God in a continuing Bible study. The last few weeks I've been preaching a sermon series entitled The Final Journey to Jerusalem. It details Jesus' 15-mile journey the last time of his life as he traveled toward Jerusalem knowing that he was going to give his life. Of course, he would be resurrected and would become the salvation method and mode by which mankind can be saved. Along this 15-mile journey, there were several things that transpired, several amazing occurrences and stories that Jesus told, interactions with people. And one very interesting one is located in the book of Luke, chapter 18, verses 9 through 14. It is the account of the Pharisee and the publican. Now let's talk about these two individuals. The Pharisee in the time of Jesus was a very religious person. It was a sect of religious people. They were very strict in the Mosaic law, but Jesus confronted with them many, many times. As a matter of fact, the Pharisees sought to kill Jesus and were part of the group that did consent to the death of Jesus. So Jesus conflicted probably with the Pharisees as much or more than any other group. The publican was a very despised individual in Jewish culture. They were a tax collector, literally working for the Roman government. They collected taxes for this foreign oppressor against their own countrymen. They were well despised and probably were the lowest thought of, one of the lowest thought of groups in Jewish society. So here you had this seemingly esteemed, well-respected Pharisee and this terribly thought of publican or tax collector. Now the Pharisee goes into the temple and he prays, but he prays in a very self-serving manner about how good he is and about how righteous he is. And the tax collector prays a very humble prayer. God, I'm not worthy. Forgive me. It's a prayer of repentance. You have these two contrasting images of a very self-exalted, self-righteous individual and a very humble, repentant individual. Now Jesus said the tax collector, the publican, was the one who would go home forgiven by God. Why? Because of his repentant attitude, because of the way he approached God. Today as we approach God, the Bible says anybody who exalts themselves will be humbled, but anybody who humbles themselves, God will exalt. Today, as you approach God, I want to ask you to do it with a repentant attitude. No matter who you are, I want to tell you something, and I don't mean it offensive, but none of us in our own self, no matter how hard we try or how good we are worthy in the sight of God. Only through the mercy, the grace, and the blood of Jesus Christ covering our sins are we acceptable in the sight of God. So take the attitude of the tax collector. Repent, cry out for God's mercy, and you'll be found righteous in the sight of the Lord. I want to continue this study next time on our next Sunday reflection. I look forward to spending that time with you. God bless you as you reach out to the Lord in that humble, repentant attitude. Have a good day. God bless you.